Hello there, my fellow Aspect Warriors, and welcome back to another lore video from the boundless universe of Warhammer 40k. Today, we are gonna be returning to our favorite race of haughty, arrogant, yet ultimately very advanced race known as the Eldar. And no, I am not calling them the Eldari. I'm sorry I haven't made any other Eldar videos lately, but for whatever reason, they kinda get limited views. Which I find bizarre because I always thought they were the second best good guy faction, so to speak. Either way, today we will continue the topic from our previous video, aka the paths of the Eldar. We already talked about the path of the warrior, so today we will focus on the path of the seer. I am your host, the Grimdark Narrator, and without further ado, let us proceed, shall we? The Seers are essentially the most potent form of the Eldar Psykas. They are members of the Eldar race who have first passed through many other different paths. This, in turn, allows them to master the full power of their mind, and thus command their psychic powers without fear of attracting demons or creating rifts within the warp when they unleash their abilities in their most potent form. Those that pursue such disciplines are said to walk down the path of the seer, or the path of the witch, where they gain proper training and experience in the use of their naturally potent psychic abilities. The development of these powers comes through the use of special seer runes, which are made of wraith bone and kept in special bags or cases. These items can be thousands of years old, and passed from one seer to the next one, with new runes being added by each seer to use the item. In addition, these Eldar wear spirit stones holding the souls of dead seers, who serve as spirit guides who can help their charge master the path of the seer while protecting them from the dangers of the Immaterium. The spirits are the ones who gather the power of the warp and channel it through the runes, in order to provide psychic energy to the seer. Through this manner, both the spirit stones and the runes serve essentially as psychic fuses that protect the vulnerable Eldar mind as the seer channels it to produce various effects. Every seer explores their psychic potential in their own way, with some learning to move objects via telekinetic force and to create living symphonies of shape as well as movement. Others instead use their talents for psychic empathy for healing purposes or to counsel others in psychic pain. The range of abilities open to a seer is vast and largely dependent on the other roles the seer has explored and mastered while walking the other Eldar paths. An example of this can be an individual who lived the life of an artisan or a bone singer and then learned to apply their psychic powers to the structuring and arrangement of matter, into various constructs needed by the craft world. The Farseers are the most powerful of the Eldar Psykas, who were once warlocks, but have become lost on the path of the seer forever, in the same way that the Exarchs are wed forever to the path of the warrior. A council of the most powerful seers generally governs a craft world. They possess a diversity of psychic specialties, with divination being the most common skill. There are two other kinds of Eldar seers, in the form of the warlock and the spirit seer, but we'll get to those in a couple of minutes. The role of the Farseer in society is to look into the future and try to discern the best course for the Eldar to take. This is done through the casting of runestones, fragments of wraithbone, and other psychosensitive materials that react to the convoluted, probabilistic kinds of space-time. By reading the flow of these stones, the Farseers can often determine what will be the most beneficial course of action, although it is very rare that they can discern true results any great distance into the future. On occasion, a powerful Farseer will receive a portent of some calamitous event, and be able to steer the Eldar away from disaster and doom. With so very few Eldar remaining, compared to humanity for example, the Farseers attempt to preserve every Eldar life that they can. However, this ability to see the future and react upon what is seen has caused the Eldar to be distrusted by all the other races, basically. Occasionally, a Farseer will see that by attacking a certain world, a fleet, a base, or even a person, Eldar lives will be somehow saved. Eldar forces will then suddenly attack without reason, and quickly withdraw as soon as their goal was accomplished. This, along with the Eldar tendency to view all the other intelligent races as inferior, has led many other sentient races to deem them as fickle, unreliable, and supremely untrustworthy. Also, the most powerful Farseers have even shown the ability to steer future events, so that other races will fight each other rather than the Eldar. One of the greatest examples of this situation is when the famous Eldrad Ulfran of Ulfwe secretly facilitated the rise of a certain orc warlord named Gazgul Mag-Uruk Fraka, who would become eventually a significant enemy of the Imperium of Man. The Farseers lead the Eldar in both times of war and peace. On the battlefield, their powers of precognition allow them to foresee the enemy's attacks and movements, and warn their comrades against imminent changes on the battlefield. As many Farseers age, however, their bodies slowly turn into a form of psychically active crystal, a transformation caused by their constant exposure to the chaotic energies of the Immaterium. When the time has come for this transformation to be completed, they go to a place called the Dome of Crystal Seers, that is present within every craft world. It is here that they join the crystalline bodies of the Farseers which came long before them. A warlock is an Eldar Seer or Psyker who previously walked the path of the warrior of an Eldar craft world and now uses his psychic powers to help lead Eldar warhosts. Warlocks who lose themselves upon this path can become Farseers. The most aggressive and warlike of all the potential variants of the path of the Seer is that of the warlock. Since the warlocks are Seers who once trod the path of the warrior, their previous experience as aspect warriors allows them to harness their most destructive impulses when using their psychic powers in combat. The ornate helmets worn by warlocks on the field of battle are kept in the shrines of the warrior aspects as a sign of the close link between the warlocks and their former status as aspect warriors. A warlock can only attain that status by returning to the aspect shrine that he once belonged to and receiving the helmet from the shrine's exarch as part of the same blood ritual undergone by the aspect warriors. A warlock not only learns to use the psychic runes of war, but is also able to wield the Witchblade, a powerful Eldar force weapon. Witchblades arrive and twist with living runes of the Eldar lexicon that focus the inherent power of the warlock's mind into destructive energy. In the hands of a warlock, a witchblade strikes with a devastating burst of psychic force that can incinerate an enemy where they stand. Whenever the craftworld Eldar go to war, their warlocks accompany their forces of aspect warriors and guardians. They use their psychic powers both to protect the Eldar warriors and to wreak havoc among the enemy. A single thought wave from a warlock can instill courage in his comrades or sear the souls of the Eldar's enemies. Though not as psychically powerful as the Farseers, few of the psychers found among the other intelligent races can equal the arcane might of a warlock, or match their combat prowess with the power of the Immaterium. Those warlocks who specialize in summoning and guiding the spirits of the Eldar dead that exist in the infinity circuits of the craft worlds are known as the Spirit Seers. Their role in combat is to direct and command the Eldar Wraith Guard and Wraith Lord units that are deployed in the more dire military situations faced by the craft world units. Both of these types of Eldar units are Wraithbone constructs that are animated by a spirit stone at their hearts holding the soul of a dead Eldar. The use of such units is seen as little better than engaging in necromancy among the majority of the Eldar, but the practice is tolerated because the Eldar's low population makes reliance upon their dead a necessity, if the race is to survive in its weakened state. The Spirit Seer's special training has hardened their own souls against the danger of becoming too enthralled by their command over the dead, and thus becoming actual necromancers. Spirit Seers are more common among the Eldar of craftworld Ayandan. That's because this particular craftworld has a very small population and even fewer warriors following the assault upon it in 992 M41 by the Tyranid High Fleet Kraken. And this, my friends, has been what I wanted to tell you about the Eldar Path of the Seer for today. As we progress through Eldar lore, I am very likely to return to these topics one day and make some more detailed videos about the Farseers, the Warlocks, and more. If you were an Eldar, would you feel drawn to these two paths? Or would you rather stick to civilian life or the path of the warrior? Let us all know what your thoughts are on these paths in the comments below. Was this episode informative or entertaining? In that case, please click the like button and subscribe for future content. Thank you all for watching, and I wish you all an awesome day. Isha's blessings be upon you.